Okay, in today's class, we'll study about the early management approaches. So here we are going to discuss about Taylor's scientific management, Foyal's administrative management, and bureaucracy. So the general approach is for Taylor's in Taylor's scientific management. The general approach we'll discuss first. So he developed a standard method for performing each job. Next, he also selected workers with appropriate abilities for each job. He also trained workers in standard method. He supported workers by planning work and eliminating interruptions. He also provided wage incentives to workers for increased output. So students, these 5 points we'll be understanding in our principles. When we are discussing principles, we'll be understanding in detail about these 5 points. Okay, yeah. So these are the 5 principles of Taylor's scientific management. So whatever generally we have understood in the last slide, here we are going to understand it in detail. Okay, time and motion study. So in time and motion study, Taylor, he divided a large work into small chunks of works, and he observed 2 things in that. So those small chunks of work were given to people, and when they were doing, he observed how much time they did the work. So he used to do this by using a stopwatch. So he would come to know how much time is required to do the each job. That is about the time study. Next one about the motion study. In motion study, using the camera, video camera, what he used to do is, for doing any work, he used to observe the motion. Okay, now let us understand, what do you mean by observing the motion? Observing the motion means he would observe which motion is required to do that particular work and which motion is not required. So all the useless motions were removed, because this when you remove the useless motions, you would do only the useful motions. By that, the time would reduce, and also your work would become more efficient. So to do all these things, to do the work more and more efficient, we used to do this time and motion study. Next one is differential payment. Again, here, to make the work more efficient, what Taylor did is nothing but he used to pay good amount of wages or money for the person who used to work efficiently. So when he did this, all the efficient workers got motivated, and they continued to do better work. So that once again, due to the people's a more efficient work, it was good for the organization. And in another side, the people, those who were not working that well, or the inefficient workers, they also started to work more efficiently to get more payment. Okay, so when they started to work more efficiently, obviously it was better for the organization. Next is drastic reorganization of supervision. Earlier, supervision was done from only one particular area. Later on, Taylor divided the peoples into small groups, and every group was supervised by a different set of people. So by doing this, these different supervisors, they could keep continuous watch over their group, so that efficiency increased. Scientific training and recruitment. So some workers were having some particular skill, some good skill. So whoever is good in whichever skill, so he was given training in that particular skill, due to which he did those, he became expert in that particular skill, and it was good for the organization. Next one, 5th one, he intimated friendly cooperation between the management and the workers. So students, if the relation between the workers and the management is good, and if it is very friendly, people could do the work more efficiently. So this is the Taylor's principles, and whatever we are discussed in the last slide is the overall gist of these principles. So next, let us understand about the contributions and criticisms of the Taylor's scientific management. Contributions are nothing but the advantages, and criticisms is nothing but the disadvantages. So in the contributions, he demonstrated the importance of compensation for performance. So whenever the compensation is given more, obviously people would do better, so performance increased. He also initiated the careful study of tasks and jobs. So students, by time and motion study, careful study of work was done. So properly we could know, or we came to know, like what is exactly is happening in the job. Next one, he demonstrated the importance of personnel and their training. So he also made us know that training is very important. Next one is criticism. They did not appreciate social context of work and higher needs of workers. So all the work was of similar kind and the needs of workers were not given importance. He did not acknowledge variance among individuals. He also tended to regard workers as ununiform and ignored their ideas. So here there was no scope for any innovation. Now this is about the Taylor's scientific management. Next one, we'll understand about the administrative management by Henry Fayol. The second one, administrative approach. In this administrative approach, he focused on organization rather than the individual. He also given or perfected the functions of the management like planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, staffing, and controlling. Now let us understand the 14 principles of administrative management. The first one is division of labor. So students, different people were skilled in different kind of work and they were divided into that particular kind of work and they were given that kind of work. So he divided the workforce into different sections and categories. Authority. So authority is nothing but we are given special permissions to do the work and it is our responsibility to complete that work within the given time. Discipline. In an organization, everything should be well organized. So that is called as discipline. All the area, maybe people, maybe material, or maybe any other things. Fourth one, unity of command. So unity of command means always the instruction should be received from one particular boss. There should be one boss for a person. Unity of direction. Unity of direction is nothing but the organization's interest. Okay, the interest and the person's interest should be going in the same direction. Subordination of individual interest. Subordination of individual interest means the organization's interest is given more priority over the individual's interest. Remuneration. Remuneration is fair salary and wages should be given to the person according to the work what they are doing. Centralization. Centralization is nothing but one particular the command is given from one particular area to all the different sections and the proper command should be given. Scalar chain. Scalar chain is nothing but from the lower level to the upper level, there should be properly organized structure of posts. For example, if you take a software industry, in a software industry, the lower level is software engineers in the most of the cases and upper level is CEO. So that should be properly defined, like software engineers, above him the senior software engineer, above him the team lead. So that particular proper chain should be there from lower to upper. Next one is order. Order means there should be a proper organized thing. Okay, order is nothing but a proper organized way for person, for people, people person both are same, or for material. Everything should be in its proper place. Everything should be in its proper place. It's order. Equity. Equity is nothing but everyone should be treated equal. They should be given equal importance. Next, stability and tenure of staff. Staffs should not be continuously changed or must not be fired every now and then because this causes an instability in the organization. So staff should be retained. Initiative. People should take initiative to do the work. They should have innovation. They should have innovation in doing the work more efficient and more simpler. They also should do the work more effectively. Esprit de corps. Esprit de corps means team spirit. Everyone should work well in a team. Contributions. This ensured contributions of the administrative management. So this ensured smooth business. it's good for managing information through people criticisms. So it leads to the formation of small groups. It results in the dissatisfaction of workers. Then these principles result into mechanized structure. So the whole structure became more and more mechanized. So next we'll discuss about the bureaucratic management by Max Weber. So here it focuses on the overall organizational system and is based upon firm rules, policies and procedures, a fixed hierarchy and a clear division of labor. So students, this bureaucracy here, everything is properly defined. One particular rule is made and everyone is complied to work according to that rule. And that rule is basically written, most of the thing. So written, and everyone should work according to that rule. So that is the bureaucratic management here. A person, he cannot do his own innovation or his own work. So that is about the bureaucratic system. So here six principles are, again, once again, division of labor. Yeah, as we already discussed. Okay, if a person is specialized in some particular work, he should be given that particular work to do. And similarly, all the people should be divided. Then similar hierarchy of authority. Okay, the proper hierarchy of authorities should be done. That is the hierarchy of authority. Okay, next rules and procedures. Next one is impersonality. Final one is employee selection and promotion. So these are the five principles of bureaucratic management. Again, it also has its contributions and criticisms. First one is here everything is a standard operating procedure. So here everything is done according to a procedure. Okay. So he says as the procedure was there, it became very much easy to do the work. And here everyone had an equal chance to succeed. And the organizing became very, very perfect. And it also became very, very effective. Again, there were criticisms here also. So innovation was reduced because everyone was working according to a standard procedure. So there was no room for innovation. And even there was a poor financial management and there was the decreased employee morale. Thank you.